Would you like to know how to set up the chart of accounts for a property management service company? Well, then you should watch this video, Property Management Service Company Input the Chart of Accounts. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Now you may well ask, what is the chart of accounts? Basically, the chart of accounts is the general ledger. In the old days, it was called the general ledger, and physically it was a notebook where each page in the book was a separate account. Then you might ask, what is an account? Well, in order to understand what the chart of accounts is, and in order to understand what an account is, let's clearly define each item. An account is an individual record of transactions. You need an account for each bank account, credit card account, income source, and expense that your property management company has. You will need other accounts as well. The chart of accounts window allows you to delete, edit, and add accounts to the chart of accounts. Now, that's what it means to manage the chart of accounts. It means having the ability to remove an account that you don't need. And if the QuickBooks software does not let you delete the account, you can click to make the account inactive so it won't clutter up the list and you can see your accounts more easily. And of course, it gives you the ability to add accounts. Now, this is a typical example. This is not our chart of accounts, but it's a typical example of the way the chart of accounts window would look in a QuickBooks company. And when you put in the information and add the accounts, you will add the account name, and you will also be required to add something else. You will be required to add account type. Now, you must be very careful. Account type in QuickBooks is not the same thing as account type when studying accounting theory. So, account name can be anything you want. As long as you spell it the way you need to spell it, the names of the accounts will show up exactly as you typed them into the chart of accounts, and they will show up on reports exactly the way that you named them in the chart of accounts. But account type, when you put that in and you choose it, you will be choosing account type from a preset pull-down list. So there's a finite number of account types for you to choose from. So then the question is, how do you know the right account type? Well, account type determines the type of transactions that QuickBooks allows you to record into the account. Account type determines what reports and what part of reports the account will be displayed in. So here is our example chart of accounts. And we're going to put this in right now, step by step, exactly as you see it. Notice I put all of them in capital letters. And the two that are in lowercase are two accounts that QuickBooks created and added to the chart of accounts because we need them whether we know it or not. So, when we add the accounts, we'll keep them in capital letters so that we can clearly distinguish between the accounts that we added and the accounts that QuickBooks gave us. To open the chart of accounts window in QuickBooks, we click List, Chart of Accounts. Notice QuickBooks actually gave us four accounts, but we don't need the two payroll accounts. The problem is if you right click on a payroll account and you click delete, it won't let you. You have to click on it, go to the bottom left and click Account, Make Inactive, and then it will disappear. Same thing with the other payroll account. Select it by clicking on it. Click Account, Make Inactive, and then it will not clutter up the list. Don't worry. Any inactive accounts that you removed, you can click this box and you can see them. And if you want to bring them back to the list, you can right-click by selecting them and then choose Make Account Active, and then it will show up again on the list. So let's make the account inactive so that we only have the two base accounts that we need. And now we'll enter our accounts one at a time. Cash in Chase Bank. No problem. Account, new. Now, you will only get this window for the first account you add, or if you add accounts one at a time. But if you are adding accounts many in a row, you will save the next window. Watch. So the first one is bank. Click continue. Now this is the window we will stay in to add all the rest of the accounts by clicking save and new. And all of the different account type choices are here. The first one is bank. And again, you could name it anything you want and spell it any way you want. Just be aware that exactly how you spell it is how it will show up on the reports. Save and new. Now, if we look behind us, we see it was added to the list. So what's the next one? Management fees income. Okay, that's an income type of account. And then we click save and new, and you can see it was added to the account. In our example, the rest are expenses: delivery, electricity, finance charge, expense. Now, if I click save and new, it remembers the type. So, oh, sorry, electricity, what was the other one? We put in delivery. So then this one will be electricity. Finance charge. Okay, telephone. See what else we have here. Maintenance, repairs, and supplies. So maintenance, see how quickly it goes, and we're done. When I click save and close, now you can see that we have the chart of accounts, and look how similar it looks to the little diagram that I made for us. Okay, but we're not technically finished. We have to put in one more account in the chart of accounts, the most important account. One more account to add. The name of that account will be called Rent Payable to Landlord Clients. It's a liability account on your financial statements because it represents what you owe to the landlord between the moment you collected the rent from the tenant and the moment you pay the landlord the rent. It represents the total money that you owe to all landlord clients in total for the collected rent minus whatever expenses you paid on their behalf during the month. It shows the total of what you expect to pay out to all landlords in the coming month. Now, it must equal the total balance of all landlord clients together. That's the reason for the rent payable to landlord clients. So, how do we accomplish this? How do we make an account that will do that for us? The way to do that is to make sure that all the client's balances add up to that account. The only way to have an account in QuickBooks that does that is to make the account type equal to accounts receivable. That's the account type of the account that represents the total money that we owe to all landlord clients at the moment that the tenants pay us the money. Now, try to remember, account type in QuickBooks is not the same thing as account type when studying accounting theory. Accounts receivable, when you study accounting theory, is equal to what the customers owe us. But if you have experience in business and you are an experienced accountant, you understand that functionally speaking, accounts receivable type in QuickBooks is equal to the balance of a specific set of customer transactions. That's what it means in practicality, not in accounting theory. So experienced people understand this. People who only studied accounting in school sometimes have trouble swallowing this because they don't understand what's important when you're actually working on a job. Our clients' balances will be negative because we owe them the money until we pay them. This will make a credit balance for the amount we owe, and the account will correctly show on the credit side of the trial balance. So this way, we can see that it equals the total of all clients, as well as having the correct balance before making the financial statements. Now, for non-experienced people, I'll give you some simple information that you can circle back to understand. Your trial balance will be completely correct if you follow this method. You can export your trial balance before making your financial statements, or you can make a normal, simple, monthly accountant adjustment to move the account to the correct side of the balance sheet if you need to print your balance sheet from QuickBooks instead of exporting the trial balance and making the statement that way. So let's just go ahead and add it, okay? What's the name of it again? Rent payable to landlord clients, and it's an accounts receivable type of account. Account, new, and it's an account receivable type of account, which you could also choose from here. Rent payable to landlord clients. Okay. Save and close, and now we have everything we need in the chart of accounts.